We're going to start it. This is not part of the questioning, but did you get the black-eyed peas when you got home?
I haven't eaten anything yet.
Haven't eaten anything?
No. I've just been looking around more or less since I've been back.
Now, get down to the serious side of it, Elvis. Now that the Army's part of the past, can you give us in detail some of your future plans?
Well, the first thing I have to do is to cut some records. And then after that, I have the television show with Frank Sinatra. And then I have the picture with Mr. Wallace. And after that, I have two for 20th Century Fox. And after that, heaven knows, I don't. I suppose it'll keep me busy the rest of this year, you know. After that, I don't know.
Well, Elvis, now you're really home. How does it feel?
It's pretty hard to describe, I'll tell you. It's hard to get used to, you know. I mean, I've been looking forward to it for 2 years, and all of a sudden, here it is. It's not easy to adjust to it.
Now that you are back, as you look back on your 2 years in the service, what was the most important thing that happened to you during your 2 years, whether it was overseas or here in the States?
Well, there were a number of things that happened. I had quite a few interesting experiences. Slip out in the snow. HC rations, you know, all the regular thing. But I suppose the biggest thing of all is the fact that I did make it. I made it just like everybody. I mean, I tried to play it straight, you know, like everybody else. And I made a lot of friends that I never would have made otherwise. And all in all, it's been a pretty good experience, you know.
Elvis, you still have time to serve now for Uncle Sam. Have you given any thought as to where you're going to serve your reserve training?
Well, sir, I will be on the reserve status here in Memphis at the reserve center here. But they have a clause which covers people with traveling jobs. If you have a traveling job or if you live too far away from the reserve center, they put you on standby. Whereas you don't have to make their meetings, but you are subject to be called in any emergency or anything of that nature.
Elvis, one of your future commitments, as you mentioned, is the Frank Sinatra show on the ABC television network. Do you have any idea of when this will be aired?
Now, I really don't know the exact date. I would imagine it's somewhere around the 1st of May.
If you'll forgive me, I have one other part to my question. We understand, speaking of Frank Sinatra, that there has been some rumor about Nancy Sinatra and yourself. Is there a romance in the making here?
No, sir, I'm afraid not. I only met her in Fort Dix. And she gave me a gift from Frank. And it was very brief. I think she's engaged to Tommy Sands. I don't think he would appreciate that.
Thank you very much.
Elvis, you think the music has changed since you've been out of the service? I mean, since you've been in the service?
Possibly, yes. I can't say, really. I haven't been here long enough to even know. Excuse me. The only thing I can say is that if it has changed, well, I would be foolish not to try to change with it, you know. But as of now, I have no reason to change anything.
As to your acting, you have stated you would like to be a more serious actor. And do you plan to possibly go to some school or some dramatic school?
Well, it wouldn't hurt me any to go to school, but I learn best by experience. I never was very good in schools of any kind. And it's going to take me a long time and a lot of experience.
But that is your ultimate ambition?
But as of the present time, it really is. That's what I want to do.
Elvis, you were asked about Nancy Sinatra. How about any romance? Did you leave any heart, shall we say, in Germany?
Not any special one. There was a little girl that I was seeing quite often over there that her father was in the Air Force, and Actually, they only got over there about 2 months before I left. I was seeing her, and she was at the train, at the airport when I left. And there were some pictures made of her. But it was no big romance. I mean, the stories came out, the girl he left behind, and all that. It wasn't like that. I mean, I had to be careful when I answer a question.
How was in your service life, which did you find the most difficult, when you went into basic training, or when you got over into Germany, over with the experienced soldiers? Which gave you the hardest time?
Well, basic training wasn't hard for me at all. It was harder afterwards, after I had gotten into a regular outfit. Not the service itself, but just the surroundings, and I was in a strange land, and the outfit I was in, they had quite a bit of field duty. We stayed in the field 6 months out of the year. And it gets cold in Germany. It snows quite a bit. And it was pretty hard to adjust to.
One thing further on that. Do you have any advice for the boys your age who are now going to have to put in a certain amount of duty in the service?
Well, the only thing I can say is to play it straight and to do your best, because you can't fight them. They've never lost yet, you know? And you can't fight them. So you can make it easier, you can make it hard on yourself. I mean, if you play it straight, get the people on your side, let them know you're trying, you, as the Army would say, you've got it made. And if you're going to try to be an individual or try to be different, you're going to go through 2 years of misery.
Elvis, when do you think you'll record again? And when you do you think you'll lean toward the ballad-type music or the more upbeat sound?
Well, as far as when I'll record it, I really don't know. Possibly this week or next week. And what I'll record, I don't know yet. I've got quite a few songs to choose from. I've collected over the 2 years, but I don't know exactly what type or what instruments I'll use, whether it be the Firestone Orchestra or Monty Vonnie or what. I really don't know yet.